Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we were talking about use formic hook and how we can do the validations. So we can see that result here. If we are not passing anything and properties touched, then we will see this required parameter, right? If you just start adding something, and if you are start adding something which is more than 5 characters, then also you will see the error, because this is how we have set the validation criteria. Okay, now what all different ways to add this validation criteria? We can use schema or validate method. So here, like, we have added the validation for password and email, so we can actually little bit customize it. We can also validate the email properties, like email is provided in the correct format or not. So I just added this regex also, just to test the values we are getting in the email, that which will show invalid email address. Okay, nothing more. And the password should be of 6 character in length. Okay, should be greater than 6 character. Okay, now same thing can we do with validate schema. Here we are just writing the validate method. Another thing is you can actually write validate schema and you can pass it. So if you just save it and we'll see, then it will start working with that schema, invalid email address. This is fine, right? Now the same validation schema, I will just convert it into the validate schema, like form schema. Okay, and here I will be using yup, so I need to import that. So yup, we can import import everything as from yup library. So this is the step one. In step two, we can just replace this validation scenario with that schema. So here we can just assign our schema which we are going to create. So it is like yup.object. So this yup object, and then the shape of the object something look like this. Here we are going to have email and password. Okay, so if you already have a validation schema, you can paste it. Invalid email address, password, the minimum length we are going to set is 6 characters. Email is required, valid email is required. So you don't need to use regex and all, because you are using this validation schema mechanism. And the form schema you can pass in the validation schema. Validation schema is pointing to this form schema. Okay, same thing, we have converted something like this. Okay, and our form yup is not defined, so we have to import it. Okay, sorry, it should be yup, not yum. Okay. Let me just see how we are importing yup module. So I think it should be import everything as yup from yup library. Okay, we can actually check this in the node modules. Give me a second. Okay, this is in lower case, not in upper case. It is something like this. Sorry for that. Okay, where are we using yup in upper case? I mean, we can import it with upper case, but here it should be in the lower case, because this is the library name. Okay, now it should be fine, I think. Yeah, that is correct. And now if I just do this, correct invalid email address, now it will become valid. Okay, so we are just now using this yup validation schema, and things are easier for us now. Okay, so this is how we are doing it. So this is all about hooks. I mean, you can customize it. You can have n number of form fields, input type, text box, radio button, checkbox. And we are just getting this formic instance. In this formic, you are, everything is available in the formic. And you can keep using it. So formic dot, you can say touch property, formic dot values, formic dot errors, formic dot handle change, formic dot handle submit. Everything is available there. Okay, thanks everyone.